February and March minutes?
I've got March.
Ken got it for us, he took care of us today, yeah.
Okay, how did you get this stuff, so, okay.
Yes.
There's an extra set of February and March.
Today is Thursday, April 20th, 2017, the time is 6:30 PM, and the regular meeting of the Greensburg Redevelopment Commission is now called to order. At this time, please silence your electronic devices. For everyone would please stand, we'll have a pledge of allegiance to the flag.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
To comply with Title VI of the Civil Rights Act of 1964, the city requests that participants in this meeting complete a voluntary anonymous survey that is available on the table in the back of the room, over by the door. Roll call, Jody, would you conduct a roll call, please?
Sure. David Weigel?
Present.
Adam Wenzel?
Present.
Ken Dornick?
Present.
Biden McKenzie? Absent. Shannon McLeod? Absent. Jody Kaufman?
Present.
Thank you. Minutes of March 16th, 2017 meeting. Are there any corrections to the minutes? If there are not any corrections, they'll stand approved as presented. Item two, update of project status for phases.
We approved it last month. We just have to sign it later.
Update of project status for phase two. Mr. May, do you have anything to report for
Good
us?
Good evening. Not an awful lot, but a little bit. Our consultant continues to work with the environmental process. They have submitted the draft environmental assessment document. NDOT had reviewed it, returned some comments. Our consultant responded to those comments, returned it. Someone different from NDOT reviewed the resubmittal, and they had some different comments. So those are going back in again early next week, and we now hope to have all of the environmental work completed by the 1st of September this year. We'll have hopefully a public hearing in middle, late June. And then if that occurs in the 1st of September, start appraisals around the 1st of October, and hopefully have right-of-way acquisition completed by July of 18, and looking for a January of 19 letting. There's not a lot else going on with the project until this environmental work is concluded. We do have the appraisal problem analysis back from our consultants. What I'm handing you is a list of the properties involved and the determined appraisal methodology. There's three or so different levels of appraisal depending on the value of the property, the damages, relocation considerations, and those sorts of things. And so the fees per parcel are listed on what I handed you. On the very first one there on the list, there's also a secondary appraisal that's going to be required on that one. Interestingly enough, the fees are pretty highly regulated by NDOT. They tell the consultants what they will pay for this kind of work. The whole thing, and this is just the appraisal cost, the whole thing comes to $72,360, of which $57,888 will be eligible for federal participation, and the city share will be $14,472. I let you know this, and I guess I ask for your concurrence, but quite frankly, there's no choice about this. I can sign these are the seven appraisal problem analysis. There's a document for each of the seven properties. And there are seven because one particular owner owns two pieces of property in different names. will notice that when you look there. So I will sign the APAs and get those returned. It's not the most urgent thing because we can't advance that part any further until we have the environmental document. Questions?
I guess all this back and forth with NDOT, you mentioned hope to have a hearing, public hearing in June. Didn't you say a month or two ago you hoped for April or May at the latest at that time?
I think at that time we were hoping to do it in May. So we've slipped another month. We, as it was explained to me, we've encountered an additional round of review that we had not anticipated or hoped for. Sadly enough, it's part of the process.
Why did that additional review come up?
It was explained to me that our consultant submitted and not reviewed their initial draft document, and our consultant resubmitted, and a different individual at NDOT reviewed the resubmittal and had different comments. There is still a possibility, I think Federal Highway has seen this document. I don't think they formally reviewed at this point. There is a possibility that Federal Highway could have some issues that need to be addressed. Generally, it's been my experience that NDOT is more particular than Federal Highway, so if you can get past NDOT, you're usually in very good shape.
What if Federal Highway does, is this going to push?
It can push us back further, yes, that's a possibility. We're trying to work with guarded optimism.
Lots of patience.
Yes, it's just how they go sometimes. We should count some of our blessings that we had no Section 106 of the National Historic Preservation Act involvement on this project. There's another place that time can be invested. So we were fortunate not to have that involvement. Anything else?
Thank you.
Thank you, Ron. Item 3 on our agenda, project list. Specifically, item 2 on our list, request from Greensburg Schools. Mr. Hunter, would you mind coming up? But I have,
That's fine, you can ask.
We've all.
You guys want to see me.
Yeah.
Thank you. As you can see from the request, we've requested $150,000 for the next 3 years as a pass-through back to Greensburg Schools on monies that we've lost due to the TIF in that area. We understand the importance of the TIF to the development of Greensburg, and we are very supportive of that process, but it has put a great burden on us in the last few years with reductions in especially our CPF and with what we've been trying to do with technology across our district. Probably since the TIFs really came into play, we've lost over $1 million from the TIF process, and those are monies that go directly towards our technology and also towards improvements across our district in capital improvements. None of these monies will go towards revenues, salaries, anything like that. Everything that we get is going to go directly back into our capital project and directly into the funds that will support technology. I gave you a list of some of the things and costs associated with that. If you look at the main spreadsheet, you can see that we spend over $600,000 a year in our technology area across the district. So this money will greatly help us to continue doing the things that we do now for kids with technology across our district. Be glad to answer any questions that you might have.
Can some of this go towards any, if there's any adult vocational training, would any of these funds or these programs help in the adult?
Yeah, probably indirectly training? They will, because they'll go towards definitely the software packages that we use with some of the technology there at the high school. We're going to start that program this fall. a well, 4 9-week, I guess, periods for adults to take skills enhancing classes there at the high school in the new technology area that we have in our vocational center. And you know, I think it's gonna benefit that. It's gonna benefit the ECHO group that we do in the summer, or starting this summer with our incoming freshmen, 38th graders that we'll have going to the high school and gonna be doing hands-on, a lot of tech involved with that, with the kids to get them acclimated to high school and kind of get a little catch with them with some of the adults working in the building. It's our most at-risk kids that that might drop out of high school. We want to do everything we can. And then, of course, we'll use it in our biomed classes and in our Project Lead the Way. And then also, if you see there's a whole list. Since we are one-to-one across the district on that first page, you'll see some of the different programs that we use and the cost of those, like MION and IXL Math. We also have some other things that we're looking at. We had a meeting today administratively talking about some of those different apps. We're looking at Study Island, the IXL, Reading Eggs Press, Reading Eggs, TRC, and testing test reading comprehension with our kids. A program called Front Row, Apex that we use at our Learning Center as a classroom activity for the kids who are at the Learning Center in our Achievement School, helps them graduate from high school. Also MION, and then It's Learning. So there's just so many different programs that we need to provide so that we can meet the needs of not only our highest students, but also our lowest students. We met yesterday with officials from the higher ed, and we're very confident Greensburg High School is going to be designated an early college next year. And that is a huge, huge designation on the part of our high school. We'll have 12 kids this year who graduate with 30 hours of transfer to any school in the state of Indiana, so they will essentially have the freshman year done. And we have another 14 kids that are a class or two away that we've worked in agreement with Ivy Tech that they'll provide those classes on campus this summer, so we could have 25 kids that are going on to college next year as sophomores. A lot of that is because of the technology, not only just the software, but the hardware that we have at Greensburg High School, and all of the different things that we have in our tech area for Project Lead the Way and Biomed. In those types of classes. So, you know, we're not going to use this money in any other way than to enhance, we think, the career skills of our kids.
I would assume, Chris, do we need to do an annual review each year, given though we are looking at 3 years on this request? Is there some kind of annual review we need to look at for the upcoming year and prior year? Any kind of documentation we need to keep for anything, for the state law or anything like that?
I'll need to check. I'm not sure as far as the annual review. I guess that's a board, you decide to do that anyway. But.
Yeah, I think even if you don't require it, it'd be a good thing to come in every year.
This, I think.
Love to share it with you what we've done, how we spent the money, because I think that's very important for the public to know.
Any other questions for Mr. Hunter?
I entertain the motion to approve this item on our project list.
So moved.
Thank you, Ken. We have a second.
Second.
Thank you. Any further discussion?
Those in favor of the motion signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Those opposed? Motion carries 4-0.
I'd like to say thank you on part of our kids and our staff in our schools and our Board of Education. It's another great example of the relationship that we have here in our community with the political entities and really with all of the different governmental groups that we have here in town. We have a tremendous relationship with those and the industry and our community. We all work together with other kids. I really appreciate that. Thank you very much.
Thanks for coming back in. We appreciate your time.
Thank you. Promise.
Item 4, additional professional services for Veterans Way Memorial Way Overlay District. Mr. May, do you have a little information?
As you all recall, when we started city started working on the proposed Veterans Way Memorial Way Overlay District, you all agreed to fund the professional services for assisting in the development of the draft ordinance. I think the original fee was $23.6. And that agreement provided for a specified number of meetings from the consultant. A little more background, the steering committee did draft a proposed ordinance and it went to the planning commission. A public hearing was held and there was some amount of public comments, and the planning commission, because of those public comments, directed the draft ordinance back to the steering committee. Since then, the steering committee has met a couple of times, one without our consultant and one with our consultant, and the last meeting with the consultant used up all of the meetings allotted in the original agreement. So I have asked the consultant for a proposed additional services for finishing up as we go forward. Their proposed fee, I think it was an additional $6,800. To assist the steering committee, and then an additional public hearing before the planning commission, and then a meeting before city council. So I am here this evening to ask if you are interested in participating any further in paying for such services.
Who else can help pay for those services? City council?
Can they really?
Okay, well, yeah, we can bring that to ask. I mean, that's the question you delay.
I think it's a hot topic, obviously. There's you know, being on the steering committee, Jody and I, we feel like we're moving somewhere. Maybe it's in the sand, but we're going somewhere with it. And I think it's the idea of what we're doing, so I don't think we necessarily want to stop what we're doing.
I mean, I would hate to give up now with the amount of work that we put in, the cost that we've paid for it already. Sure, it's not exactly what maybe I envisioned, or maybe other people as well. Clearly, that's why it's back there, but I think we made some progress, and I feel like it's not as heated as maybe we had dreamed it was originally as well. So
I guess I looked at this, and Ron and I spoke about it a little bit, and I appreciate what the steering committee's done. I think that we've come this far, as Jody said, that we need to have professional representation going forward to finish it up. I think we would just open the door up, open the can of worms up, if we tried to finish that process without the professional help that you've had so far. You know, Ron's note said that the estimate was $6,800. The letter from the company said that they could possibly reduce it to $54,000 if they had one less meeting.
They were going to send less representatives to a couple of the meetings. What's the difference?
So, to me, it's money well spent. We've already spent the initial chunk of it. I think we're many wise pound foolish if we don't continue down that process. Continue to have professional representation. That's just my opinion.
I agree. Yeah, the difference obviously between the 54 and the 6,800 was the amount of representation, who was representing us, and I think the 6,800, the additional $1,400 makes sense. With the representation that we would be getting additionally from the company helping us out. So
I guarantee a motion for approval of these additional services.
So moved.
I'll second. When you say 6,800, or we're going to change anything specific here since we did have two options.
I make a motion for the 6,800.
Second.
All right. Motion made and seconded. Any further questions or discussion?
Did that include, as we said, ideally we could do it in three, but it was
That includes four meetings.
Okay.
I will speak with them if we don't need all four of them, maybe we can save a little bit there.
All those in favor of the motion signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Those opposed? Motion carries 4-0.
Thank you.
Thanks, Ron.
Approval of claims. We have two claims this evening. One we have tabled from last month because it came in right the day of the meeting and we didn't have a chance to review. It's from Rundell Ernstberger. I think it was for the remainder of the initial $23,600. And it's for $5,900. And we have the annual monthly bill from the consultant at Construction Point. It's $7,968. So the two claims total $13,868. Somewhere on the board. Money in the bank for this month, we have $658,920.18. So obviously that could be covered. Is there a motion to approve these?
So moved.
Thank you, Adam. Is there a second?
Second.
Thank you, Tim. Any further discussion on the claims? If not, call for the question. All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Those opposed? Motion carries 4-0. Our claims are paid. There's nothing else on the agenda. Any board members have any other comments, questions? Okay. Our next meeting date is in 4 weeks on Thursday, May 18th, here at 6:30 p.m. With nothing else, we'll adjourn our meeting. Thank you all.